Hi kids, I'm Lee Kuan Yew. I'm known as the founding father of Singapore and the man who built a nation, transforming it from mud planks to a modern high-tech city. Today I'm going to be sharing my life story with you. These are my parents, my father Lee Chin Kun and mother Chua Jim Nyo. I had three younger brothers and one sister. I was the eldest in the family. I was born in Singapore on September 16, 1923 and was named Lee Kuan Yew, meaning light and brightness. My grandfather also used to call me as Harry. I was known more as Harry during my childhood years. This was a photo of me taken right after I won the first place in a baby show. Don't you think I was cute? I was very playful as a child. My father once helped me by my ears over a well for breaking his expensive jar of scented oil. I also loved playing kites with my friends. We always played to win. I always had a competitive spirit in me. I then went to Telok Kurau School. I later realized I was mildly dyslexic, meaning I had a difficulty in reading and processing languages. However, I was able to overcome it. I also openly talked about it in my later years to remove the stigma around it. If we try, we can always overcome any difficulties in life. I went on to study at the Raffles Institution. And this is where I met Kwa Gyuk Chu. She was the only girl in the institution and was a brilliant student who always competed with me in grades. Our friendship then blossomed into love as we moved from Singapore to Cambridge for our higher studies. I then attended the Fitzwilliam College and earned a double-starred first-class honors in law. It was then that I married Kwa Gyuk Chu, who is my lifelong companion and who played the supporting role in building the nation with me. We had two sons and a daughter together. During this time in Cambridge, I was deeply concerned about treatment of non-British people there. This is when I had my interest in politics. I wanted to change how people were governed when I went back to my homeland, Singapore. So I returned to Singapore in 1949 and I took up the role of a legal advisor to various workers' unions. I then started the People's Action Party, PAP, in 1954, along with other activists who wanted to attain independence. So I contested in the upcoming elections and we focused mainly on the campaigns against corruption. I also made public speeches emphasizing that this country belongs to Singaporeans. Our party won in the elections by a landslide and I became the Prime Minister of Singapore in 1959. These are the other important leaders who transformed Singapore along with me, as Rajaratnam, Goh Keng Swee, Toh Chin Chye, and Hon Sui Sen. After becoming Prime Minister, I prioritized on building a meticulously planned city with my 5-year urban renewal plan that focused on housing, greater rights for women, educational reform, and industrialization. At this time, Singapore merged with Malaysia. I then focused on establishing Housing and Development Board to provide housing for the large population. This is how we went from old Singapore and transformed it into a new modern high-tech city and one of the most prosperous countries in the world. I was also focused on keeping the city clean. We had posters in public places stating keeping our city clean is a national objective. We also had police officers and surveillance to punish anyone who was not keeping their city clean. There was no littering allowed on public places, ban on chewing gum, restriction of smoking and gambling in certain places. I brought in many rules to build and empower a self-disciplined nation. I also introduced the Keep Singapore Clean campaign and organized mass public education programs and also taught in schools the importance of a well-maintained country. We also had tree planting campaigns to make Singapore the garden city as it is known today. People refer to me as the chief gardener of Singapore. It was then in 1965, Singapore got separated from Malaysia, not by choice, but due to the differences in vision of a cohesive society. It really pained me, as all my life I believed in the merger and the union of two territories. We are connected by geography, economics, and ties of kinship. I had tears in my eyes and was at loss of words in that interview. My vision was to make this country the model of multiracial society. I made sure whatever your race, language, or religion, we will not as a majority squeeze the minority. You are all an equal citizen. I also made a speech quoting that Singapore belongs to all of us. It is not a country that belongs to a single community. This country is ours. All of us will make this country out of nothing. I declared the four official languages of Singapore as English, Mandarin, Chinese, Malay, and Tamil, and they were chosen mainly to correspond with the major ethnic groups in Singapore. You would see all the four languages on any posters or signs across the city. I also made it mandatory for all students to learn their mother tongue associated with their ethnicity so that their identity is not lost. So apart from English, student has to learn one of the three official languages of Tamil, Mandarin Chinese, or Malay. Around this time, Britain withdrew its troops from Singapore, so there was an urgent need to build defense force in Singapore. So in 1967, National Service was introduced, where it was compulsory for every male citizen to serve in the army for about 2 years. I believed it helps to promote racial harmony and self-discipline. This is one of the posters of National Service, where it says, "Our backgrounds don't matter, we serve a higher purpose." I knew that Singapore was a small city-state with no natural resources, so there was a need to export goods to develop our economy, and our greatest resource was our people. So we focused on developing international clients to do business and trade. So in turn, we were able to provide employment to many youngsters. Singapore was also the first country in the world to have a tripartite arrangement where the government, employers, and workers all come together to discuss wages and policies. So everyone was happy to work towards one goal of building the best nation. Soon, there was an emergence of high-tech industries, more foreign investments, and Singapore was established as an air and sea transport hub, and housing and finance sector developed really well. We eventually became the leading business center in Asia. Right after the merger separation from Malaysia, Singapore Airlines was ready to take to the skies in 1972. I believe the future of the airlines should depend more on the experience it leaves behind on the passengers. My other important vision was on transport model. I drew on examples from far-off Scandinavia, and I made sure that my buses and MRT, the mass rapid transit, was well connected so you can reach your destination by any means. If an idea was good, I tried it. If it didn't work, I always tried something else. In mid-1975, I decided to build a new international airport. I was also known as the brainchild of Singapore Changiairport. It has won many awards for being the best airport in the world. Singapore's passport was also one of the most valued and highly ranked passports in the world, providing access to almost 190 countries. Singapore is my legacy. It became one of the most prosperous countries in the world. People look at Singapore and say how everything works well. I made that happen by bringing in ideas from all around the world and implementing them for my countrymen. I served as a prime minister for over 31 years and a further 20 years as an advisor to the government. I passed away on March 23, 2015 at 91 years old. We Built a Nation is an exhibition that started in 2015 that explores my leadership journey and has many of my artifacts available. So kids, remember my key principles in life. Never let any disability or difficulty stop you from achieving your dreams. Always have competitive spirit. Love your country like you love yourself and your family. If an idea is good, try it. Or if it doesn't, keep trying until you succeed. Treat everyone equally and don't differentiate by race, color, language, religion, or status. Every citizen united together can build a great country. Well, that comes to the end of my life story. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like our videos, please like, subscribe, and share. Kids Light Up! See you in our next video. Bye!